हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू ऑनलाइन क्लासेस ऑफ शिवाजी ग्रुप ऑफ इंस्टीट्यूशंस। स्टूडेंट्स इन क्लास 5 सब्जेक्ट मैथमेटिक्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट चैप्टर नंबर 8 व्हिच इज एंगल्स एंड ट्रायंगल्स। एंड इन दिस चैप्टर वी आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व एक्सरसाइज नंबर 8। इट इज अ रिकॉल एक्सरसाइज, सो व्हाट यू हैव लर्न इन योर प्रीवियस क्लासेस जस्ट रिवाइज। ओके, सो क्वेश्चन नंबर ए इज गिवन, ड्रॉ अ स्केच ऑफ अ ट्रायंगल रेक्टेंगल एंड अ पॉलीगॉन विद 5 साइड्स। So you have to draw a only a sketch of a triangle. You know what is a triangle? A triangle is made up of 3 sides. So you have to draw a rough sketch. So this is a triangle. Second, you have to draw a rectangle. A rectangle is made up of 4 sides. Okay. And the third one, you have to draw a rough sketch of a pentagon. A pentagon has 5 sides. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. It has 5 sides. So it is a pentagon. Okay, students. Now, by using a compass, draw a circle of diameter 10 cm. This question is number B. By using a circle, by using a compass, we have to draw a diameter of 10 cm. So, by compass, we can draw a circle of radius 10 cm. So this is radius. So first we have to put compass to its needle here and the pencil here, and then rotate it in a circle here. Okay, then our circle of radius 10 cm. Okay, now question number C is, find the diameter of a circle whose radius is, question number C, find the diameter. First part is 2.5 centimeters. We know what is the relation between diameter and radius. In this circle, this is radius, and if we meet both ends to the circumference of the circle, then it is called diameter. So from point A to B, it is diameter, but from point O to B, it is a radius, or from point O to A, it is a radius. So here, 2.5 centimeter is a radius given. So it is a radius. So what will be its diameter? From here you can see, so diameter equal to 2 times of radius. Diameter is equal to 2 times of radius. So multiply 2 into 2.5, then you will get 5.0. So this is the diameter. Okay, students. Next question is 6 cm and third one is 10 cm. So you have to just multiply by 2, then you will find the diameter. Next question, D part is given. Give two example of parallel lines from your surroundings. So we have to first understand what is a parallel line. If two parallel lines, it is a two lines A and B, this is C, D. If they never meet each other from any point, or we can say the distance between the two lines is same everywhere, then it is called parallel lines. Okay, and if this line is cut anywhere, you will see when we increase the length of this line, then it will cut from the height of this point. Okay, so this is not a parallel line. Why? Because the distance here is maximum and distance here is minimum or shorter compared to this. So it will meet from any point. Okay, but the distance from here, which is D, it is D, this same, then it will be a parallel line. Okay, students. So from surrounding, we can see in our board, this line is, and this line, both the lines are parallel lines. Okay, and if you will see a watch, then this line and this line is the example of parallel lines. Okay, students. Next, I give two examples of perpendicular lines from your surrounding. What is perpendicular line? If the angle between two lines is 90 degrees, if the angle between two lines is 90 degrees, then it is called perpendicular lines. And we have to give two examples. So if we consider this line and this line, it is perpendicular to each other, and this is an example of perpendicular line. And same thing in board, this line and this line, these are perpendicular to each other. Okay, so these are the example of perpendicular lines from our surroundings. Next question is identify and name the rays and line segments in the following figures. First, understand what is ray and line segment. Ray and line segment. First, what is ray? A ray is a line which one end is fixed and this part can go to infinite. Okay, we can increase this part into infinite. Okay, so this is a ray. This point is fixed A and this is B. And what is line segment? Line segment is a particular part of a line and it can't be increased. Okay, so this part, from this line, this particular portion CD is a line segment. This is line segment and this is ray. Here this is ray. And what is line? A line can be increased from both ends. Okay, it can increase from both ends. So this is a line. Now from given figure, we have to find line segment and ray. You will see AB is a ray, CD is a ray. Okay, so here AB, CD, these are ray, and AC and CE, AC and CE, this is line segment. Okay student, the question number second of part F you have to do yourself. Okay, now question number G, state whether the following lines are parallel or not. As I have already told you that what is, how you can recognize a parallel line. So the distance between two lines, if the distance between two lines is same everywhere, then these lines are parallel lines. Okay, so from given figure, this is figure number first, and this is figure number second. So you can see the distance between these two lines are same everywhere. So this is a parallel line, and in this situation you will see this line will be, if we increase this line, then this line will be from here. Okay, so this, and the distance between the two points is not same, so this is not a, this is not a parallel line. Okay students, and now the last question, which is question number H. It says write true and false for statements. A circle is a polygon. First part is, a circle is a polygon. It is false. Why it is false? Because in polygons there is angle created. Okay, there is two or more than two angle, then it is called polygon. But in a circle there is no any angle, so this is false. All squares are rectangles. This is true. A square is also a rectangle of same length and breadth. Radius of a circle is double of its diameter. It says radius of a circle is double of its diameter. This is wrong. diameter is equal to 2 times of radius. So reverse it. So question number 3 is false. Every diameter of a circle is a chord. This is true. Every diameter of a circle is a chord. This is true. Now question number 5. A circle has only one center. True. A circle has only one center. And all radii of a circle are equal. This is also true. All the radii are equal. Okay students, now this exercise is completed and we will solve 8.8b in our next lecture. Okay friends, thanks for today's class.